Thank you, Andrea. My name is Chris Altmans. I'm the program manager for U.S. Communities. I'm based out of Des Moines, Iowa, and I cover a large portion of the Midwest, otherwise known as flyover country. But I am going to be giving a brief overview of the U.S. Communities program up front, and then I'm going to turn it over to Joe Tommy and Bill Thomas from Cobb County, and they're going to talk about the bid solicitation process. And then I'm going to turn it over to David, Corey, Martin, and Brent, who's going to give you some specifics on their offering as awarded suppliers through this new contract. So without further ado, let's get into the U.S. Communities overview portion of our presentation today. So U.S. Communities, if some of you are new to cooperative purchasing, is one of many national cooperative organizations in existence today. We operate on a national level, so our contracts are available in all 50 states. The way we're structured is we like to say that the U.S. Communities was born out of government for government. And the reason I say that is this used to be called the NACO purchasing program back in the late 80s, early 90s. NACO had a purchasing program. The National Association of Counties had a couple of contracts that went over very well on a national level. And in 1996, U.S. Communities was formed. NACO decided to open up their program to other public agency types, and that's when the founding co-sponsor, ASBO International, the Association of School Business Officials International, the National League of Cities, and the United States Conference of Mayors were brought on board as founding co-sponsors. More recently, the National Governors Association has become a national sponsor of U.S. Communities. In addition to our national sponsors, we have over 90 state sponsors nationally, and a great way to determine who sponsors our program at a state level is to go to our website under the About section, and it will list the local entities that sponsor our program in your state. So we operate as a nonprofit organization, and the way you can look at it is our staff, which consists of about 35 people, runs the purchasing program for these government entities. Another distinguishing factor of U.S. Communities is we have an advisory board. A lot of other cooperatives out there don't have this, and this is a very valuable tool for us as an organization, because the advisory board is made up of public purchasing professionals from around the country that provide our staff at U.S. Communities professional oversight. They help bring forth ideas on new contracts and how we can serve our public agencies better. And as you can see, just this group alone has purchased over $160 million worth of products and services through our program. So all of our advisory board members, their contact information can be found on our public website. Again, that's uscommunities.org. These are great resources for you to reach out to and have peer-to-peer conversations about U.S. Communities, and they would be more than happy to answer any questions about our program. Most of these agencies that you see listed here have served as lead public agencies for one or more of our contracts, so they can also be great resources if you have questions about our contracts that have been awarded. So you may be wondering, okay, what's in it for me? Why would I want to use a U.S. Communities contract? Number one, again, we're a nonprofit organization that is in existence to help you, the end-using agency, save both time and money on the purchasing process. Our program is completely free. All your agency has to do is register on our website, and you get access to all of our supplier contracts. There's no cost to participate. There's no annual fee. There's no minimum or maximum spend requirements. Registering simply gives you access to our contracts if you choose to utilize them. One of the huge distinguishing factors of our program is that we have a lead public agency model, which I'll describe in a little bit more detail. But that's what makes it legal and compliant for you to utilize at the local level. All of our suppliers have agreed that their U.S. communities pricing is the best overall government value that they offer government agencies. So when you look at our list of suppliers on our website, you know that you're not going to find a better price on a competing cooperative contract or a state contract. All of our suppliers have agreed and guaranteed that their best overall value is through U.S. communities. So it simplifies the process for you guys, knowing that you're getting all of our suppliers' best price through this program. We have very strict supplier commitments. We have ancillary staff on board that meets with our suppliers on a quarterly basis to make sure the contract is fulfilling the needs for our public agencies. You have a staff of purchasing program managers like myself that can serve as liaisons between you and our suppliers. So if you ever wonder, you know, I wonder if U.S. Communities has a contract for XYZ, you can reach out to your local program manager, and we can research our suppliers for you and see if they have the products and solutions that you're looking for. I highly recommend to try to reach out to your local program manager. I cover the Midwest, but we have program managers all over the country. And the best way to determine who your program manager is to go to our website and click the Contact Us tab, and it'll provide a map of the areas that each one of our program managers covers, and they're great resources for you. So highly recommend for you to reach out to your local program manager. So basically, in a nutshell, what separates us from a lot of other cooperatives is our robust bid solicitation process. I'll just use the example we're talking about today for our tractor contract. Cobb County, Georgia served as the lead agency for this particular bid solicitation. So Bill and Joe and his staff put together an RFP based on their needs and also took into consideration that 55,000 plus public agencies from around the country could potentially piggyback off this contract. Once the RFP is written, it's advertised on various bid posting sites like DemandStar, so any tractor company in the country could have responded to this bid. And then once they get the bid responses, an evaluation committee is formed. So in this instance, the lead agency is a county. And as I mentioned earlier, we have several different public agency types that can use our program. So we'll try to get together someone from maybe a college or university or a K-12 school district, or maybe even a nonprofit, try to get as many people on the evaluation committee as possible to represent all different public agency types. They'll join the lead agency, spend a few days going over the bid responses, and together as an evaluation committee, along with the lead agency, they'll score the bid responses and award the contract to the best overall value. So hopefully by me explaining that, you understand that this contract has already gone through a very competitive national bid solicitation process through a lead agency. So you're able to forego your own bid process and simply piggyback, if you choose to, off this existing contract. And also, because we have 55,000 public agencies that are part of our program, it gives you buying power, knowing that these suppliers all responded with their best overall pricing in order to win this award, to possibly use this one contract to do business with over 55,000 public agencies nationwide that are part of our program. So that's how U.S. Communities works. It's a great way for you to get the products and services you need and save time and money in the process. So I'm going to turn this over to Joe Tommy from our lead agency, Cobb County, Georgia, and he's going to talk more in depth about the bid solicitation process. Joe?
Okay, thanks, Chris. Okay, we'll give you a little bit of background on how we conducted this process. I do have Bill Thomas here with me, Bill's Supervisor of General Purchasing. And this solicitation was a real team effort between Bill and me. And I'll tell you a little bit more about Bill's involvement in this in a minute. But the again, we were assigned as the lead agency for this solicitation. It was advertised nationally as a $100 million opportunity. So we see a great deal of potential in this contract. And we had a national evaluation team. And we had procurement professionals from the County of Miami-Dade, Florida, City of Los Angeles, and the City of El Paso, Texas. We spent about 2 days here in Cobb County going through, reviewing these proposals, discussing, scoring, and finally arriving at an award decision. So it's a very intensive process. And again, we had great representation from all around the nation on our evaluation team. We issued the RFP on December 30th. On December 30th of 2016. And since this was such a large contract, we actually advertised this publicly for 6 weeks. We held a pre-proposal conference on January 12th, and then we received our proposals on January 26th of 2017. Okay, as far as the scope, this solicitation included specifications for both tractors and zero-turn mowers. And I was telling you about Bill's involvement in this. Bill's responsibility was going in and developing specifications. And he started from scratch. And I got to tell you, Bill did a fantastic job. He did a tremendous amount of research. He went out and visited local tractor dealers to gain information. And then he came back in and he put together a set of very open, competitive specifications in several different categories of tractors and mowers. So stimulate a lot of competition, and I really appreciate everything Bill did in developing those specifications. Bill actually did the hard part of putting the solicitation together. But anyway, we had a we had a solicitation for tractors, and associated with tractors, we also had implements and accessories. We looked at parts, and then we looked at any related products and services that could be furnished by those companies. And then we had a, within that solicitation, we also had several categories of zero-turn mowers, and we had the same thing. We had implements, accessories, parts, and then we looked at related products and services. And because of the great job Bill did on specifications, we got 6 good responses. So we had plenty of competition, and we had some great responses to the solicitation. Okay, as far as the evaluation factors and what we base the award on, we looked at several different factors. First of all, we looked at the proposer's ability and experience. We wanted to make sure that we were working with companies that had the capability to actually service 55,000 or potentially 55,000 public agencies. We looked at the scope of products proposed. We looked at the variety of products and how practical those products would be for public agencies. And then we evaluated the U.S. community's national supplier information. And then lastly, but very important, was pricing. So we had firm fixed prices for each one of the tractors and mowers in each category, and then we scored that on an objective formula so we would have an apples for apples comparison between all the proposers' prices. Okay, solicitation award timeline. After we evaluated the proposals for tractors, we had 2 great proposals from both AGCO and Mahindra. Again, both of them submitted outstanding proposals with very competitive prices. So we decided on that award to make a dual award to 2 companies. So for tractors, it was awarded to AGCO, who is representing Massey Ferguson Tractors, and then Mahindra, who manufactures tractors. So we got two really great tractor companies. And then on the mowers, we had several responses to that, but we determined through the evaluation process that Grasshopper offered the overall best value for this contract. As far as the term of the contract, the contract commenced on May 15th of 17, and it will run to May 14th of 2020. So we got a three-year contract, and we have options for two renewal years. So potentially we have a five-year contract. For all interested parties, you can see the RFP and the contract documents at U.S. Communities' website, www.uscommunities.org. And, of course, Bill and I are available to answer any questions regarding the contract. So feel free to either give us a call or shoot us an email, and we'll be glad to get back to you. The bid contract number is 17-6221. And I think that covers our portion, right, Andrea?
Yes. Thanks so much, Joe and Bill. Next, we'll hear from Dave Webster and Corey Maryland with AGCO Massey Ferguson. David?
Corey, I'll take you off mute. I was halfway through. thank you, Andrea. As you introduced Corey and I, I'm Dave Webster, Director of National Accounts and Government Sales at AGCO Corporation, and I office out of our corporate office in Duluth, Georgia, and Corey Maryland, our Manager of Government Sales, is officed there as well. Definitely at AGCO, we're excited to be part of the U.S. Communities Program and to be able to offer solutions under this product segment. And Andrew, if you could switch to the next slide, I'll kind of jump right into the product offering itself. And when you look at the products that are available under this contract, we're able to offer a very complete tractor offering that ranges from subcompacts to tractors above 200 horsepower. And I believe the most applicable products will be the compact range from 20 to 60 horsepower that in many instances are the right solution for mowing, snow removal, for schools, parks, and many other municipal applications. And when you look at the utility range tractors, also very applicable to this market segment. These tractors range from 60 to 130 horsepower and will do much of the same type of work as the smaller tractors, but on a larger scale, whether it be roadside mowing, beach maintenance, or numerous other jobs. And this product portfolio is very complete from a feature standpoint. And on the compact line, we'll have products that fall into a premium and super premium category. And the specification differences between those tractors really lie around the operator, station, controls, transmission options, hydraulic capacities, and maybe power takeoff options. And this really holds true for the overlap in the utility tractors as well. And when a tractor is doing multiple functions or a more complex job, we typically see a higher spec tractor go into that application. And our dealer network will be able to work with you, your purchasing managers, or yourself to come up with the right tractor, the right specifications for the job at hand. And one thing I will mention, when we look at the on our larger tractors in the range of 70 to 100 horsepower, We also run no diesel particulate filter, which helps improve performance in applications where we're not always using all of the horsepower that is available. And if we'll just jump to the next slide, Andrea, I want to talk about a few advantages that I believe we have to offer in the solutions that we can provide. As indicated by the map on the left, we have a significant distribution network that is continuing to expand and provide solutions that are delivered by a business that is either in or very close to the communities that you represent. We have over 800 dealers with just over 1,300 locations that are supported by six parts depots across the U.S. and Canada. And the product offering itself, again, is very complete in terms of the tractors as the range is expansive. And as indicated on the earlier slide, a good overlap in terms of specifications in the different horsepower ranges. And again, allows us and the dealers to match the best solution to the job at hand. And also, being based in North America, we're very interested in growing this segment of the business. We've made a significant investment in the products that fit into this segment overall. And as a corporation, due to that investment, we've really increased our focus on providing the right products, the right solutions for your needs. And if you want to roll to the next slide, Andrea, just wanted to talk about a couple of the successes that we've had as an organization selling into this segment of the market. But we definitely know there is more potential that I think we're going to be able to tap into and being part of U.S. communities. One of our most visible recent successes is 10 tractors that we have running at the airport in Atlanta, and really a combination of the right price, the right support in terms of dealer locations, and the right product features all contributed to be being able to provide this solution. And in terms of the U.S. communities contract itself, it was exciting, or it has been exciting, to see the activity over the last week and a half since it going live June 6th. But we actually had the first sale under the contract take place in New York State with West Seneca School District. The district was planning on going to bid and initiated a discussion with our dealer. And upon the dealer contacting our government sales team in Duluth, we explained the U.S. Communities program and shared that West Seneca School District was already using U.S. Communities for other solutions and products. The dealer then discussed this with the district and was able to provide the right solution for their needs through the contract, saving time for both parties and knowing that they were getting a great value. So with that, I'll turn it over to Corey Merrilin and just talk about doing business with AGCO.
Okay, thank you, David. Next slide, please. Sorry about that. So getting started with buying a Massey Ferguson or a Challenger brand tractor is really easy and can be accomplished in two easy steps. The first step is, if you're not already registered, is to register with U.S. Communities on their website. Secondly, once you've registered, you can fill out the contact request form under the U.S. Communities AGCO Massey Ferguson microsite, which is located next to the Getting Started tab. When you fill out the contact request form, all requests will go directly to the AGCO National Accounts team, and the team will then distribute the sales inquiry to the appropriate dealer. And our dealers have a great wealth of knowledge in regards to our equipment and can provide assistance with specifications and configuration arrangements. And they will also be able to assist you with pricing, shipping information, receiving and filling purchase orders. Next slide, please. So we've included this slide for reference. As you can see, we have provided links that will take you directly to the U.S. Community page for Massey Ferguson, request contact form, and dealer locator. If you choose to contact the dealer directory directly, just be sure to advise them that you are eligible for the U.S. Community's contract. You can also contact the U.S. Communities team at ACCO by email at uscommunities@accocorp.com or call us at 1-800-972-2426. In conclusion, we are very excited to be working with Cobb County and the U.S. Communities team. We see this new contract as an exciting and efficient way to provide Massey Ferguson and Challenger brand tractors to help government agencies and nonprofit organizations maintain and enhance their green spaces. It is also a new opportunity for these professionals to access some of the very best equipment available, ranging from our compact tractors to tractors above 200 horsepower. As David mentioned earlier, we have a significant distribution network that continues to expand and a product offering that provides the right solution for the job. Whether it's from mowing, snow removal, beach maintenance, park trail maintenance, or numerous other jobs. We look forward to working with you and hope to hear from you soon. Thank you again for this opportunity. Thank you, Andrea.
All right. Thanks, David and Corey. Next up, we have Martin with Mahindra.
Hi. Good afternoon. I'd like to thank Andrea and Chris with the U.S. Communities and Joe and Bill with Cobb County for the opportunity to present here to U.S. Communities. Tell you what, we'll go ahead and jump right in. So if you could advance to the next slide, please. Okay, Mahindra is excited to be partnered with U.S. Communities, and we feel that we have some of the best equipment available for your respective agencies on there. One of the strengths that we're going to offer is going to be our warranty, and this is going to be across our entire product range. As you'll see with the subcompact and the compact tractors, we're going to have a 7-year limited powertrain warranty, which we offer to our retail consumers in addition to the U.S. Communities. You'll see it's a 7-year powertrain warranty or 3,000 hours. For the higher horsepower tractors, you're looking at about 60 horsepower plus 55, 60 plus. You're looking at a standard 5-year limited powertrain warranty. Again, for the subcompact and the compact, it's going to be 7-year limited warranty standard. Higher horsepower is going to be 5-year. In addition, our dealers also participate in what's called a loaner program. So if one of the tractors that you're using, requires certain warranty work, our dealers will be able to, offer a loaner tractor so you can keep working at the job that you guys are doing right then. Excuse me. So go ahead and go on to the next slide. You'll see one of the key points that we also offer is Mahindra made a $30 million investment in the what we call the MCRD Tier 4 engine technology. And so that was a complete redesign of the engine without the need for a diesel particulate filter. So it's going to be a simple system for your owners, operators, and people that are working on it for maintenance. So there's going to be no operator involvement, no extra training required, no maintenance, no high heat when you have to do a system regeneration, and no DPF filter that needs to be replaced. Again, it's a simple system. It's going to be in engines 33 horsepower and over. We can go on to the next slide, please. Okay, and kind of the subcompact to compact range, you'll see 22 to 38 engine horsepower. We offer 17 models, including 3 cab models. They're going to feature more built-in weight and higher loader and 3-point lift capacities. It's going to be also feature larger tires for better traction, stability, and control. Again, there's going to be a multitude of implements, attachments available, including mid mowers, backhoes, snow blowers, brooms, and snow removal equipment. Okay, go on to the next slide, please. In the 40 to 55 engine horsepower range, we offer 19 models, including 7 cab models. Again, they're going to feature the similar, what we call the push more, pull more, lift more features of Mahindra tractors, more built-in weight, more three-point and loader lift capacities, again, the larger tires. These are also going to feature the MCRD engine. Again, you know, simple solution to just keep your operators using the tractor for whatever work they're doing out in the field. Next slide. And in the more utility type horsepower range, 65 to 105 engine horsepower, we're going to offer 10 models, including 4 cab models. Again, you know, one commonality across all Mahindra products is going to be that more built-in weight, the three-point, and the loader lift capacities. Again, larger tires for better traction, stability, and safety. So it's going to be designed to carry larger three-point and loader lift capacities on there, you know, to make your operators work a lot smoother, a lot easier whenever they're out in the field. If we'll go on to the next slide. Now, we consider Mahindra to be the toughest tractors on earth, and it's going to be for a variety of reasons. You know, it's not just the 7-year limited powertrain warranty, the 5-year limited powertrain warranty on the higher horsepower tractors, but again, all Mahindras are going to be built, like I said, with more built-in weight, the loader lift capacities, the three-point hitch capacities, the larger tires, the industry's best standard warranty. Again, like I said, there's going to be a whole host of standard features that are going to be that are going to come on the Mahindra tractors, in addition to plenty of attachments to help you and your operators complete their task in a, what we like to say, you know, by working smarter, not harder. And we currently have over 550 dealers in the U.S. and Canada, and we have 6 distribution centers, so Mahindra, you know, can get the products that you're going to need within, we like to say, about 7 to 10 working days. So, you know, once we get that order in, we can generally get it out, you know, basically a week to 2 weeks time. So get that, you know, right into your hand and, you know, keep you guys working on. To go on to the next slide. And again, how to get started, you know, you can visit the Mahindra microsite on the U.S. Communities webpage, you know, under suppliers, or you can, you know, find their local Mahindra dealer by visiting MahindraUSA.com, or again, that request a quote, U.S. Communities at MahindraUSA, that comes to us internally, and we'll work together with the local Mahindra dealer and make sure that we get you the equipment you need and provide the service and support that, you know, you guys are going to need.
All right. Thanks, Martin. Next, we'll hear from Brent with Grasshopper.
Hello, everybody. Thanks again to the Cobb County Purchasing Department and U.S. Communities team for the webinar today. A little bit about the Grasshopper Company. Grasshopper Mowers first rolled off the production line in 1969. We are a family-owned company based out of Mound Ridge, Kansas. We manufacture the Grasshopper zero-turn mowers that are shipped throughout the U.S. and over 40 countries worldwide. We are not just an assembler of our mower, but a manufacturer of the Grasshopper mower. We spend a tremendous amount of time in development and testing to ensure our mowers have the best quality of cut, the most comfortable ride, and exceed our customers' expectations of durability and reliability. We are focused on a premier customer experience, which has earned us a 98.6% approval rating amongst our owners saying they would purchase Grasshopper again. Next slide, please. So what is a Grasshopper? Grasshopper is a dual-lever zero-turn mower. Grasshopper offers both front-mount and mid-mount zero-turn mowers. The mid-mount, shown on the left, is a four-wheel configuration with a mowing deck underneath the operator foot platform. The front-mount, to the right, is a 5-to-6-wheel mower with cutting deck that is forward of the operator's seated position. Zero-turn mowers can reduce mowing time by 30 to 50% compared to conventional steering wheel systems. The front mount, or sometimes referred to as out front mower, has a greater reach under trees, near fencing, and Grasshopper utilizes a traction system that transfers deck weight to the drive tire for superior traction in various conditions. The out front also has a powerful cutting deck. The power fold is both your electric cutting height adjustment and electrically raises the deck for easy blade changes, compact storage, or even savings on a trailer, space savings on a trailer. Grasshopper also offers an array of implements. The diagram shows a couple of things. The different colors help to show you the integrated ISA mounting of the operator platform and the enhanced comfort of the operator seat and steering levers. Coupled with a design mesh transmission, we provide a superior driving and mowing experience. We also put metal where it matters by reinforcing strategic areas of the mower and cutting deck to give us strength and still maintain a light footprint on the turf. You'll also note the ROPS, the rollover protection system, that are certified to meet OSHA requirements and are standard on all of our mowers. Besides safety switches in the seat and controls, we also have something other manufacturers do not, with automatic neutral return. When you let go of the steering levers, the mower comes to a complete stop. This gives the operator greater control. Using the levers is as simple as pushing a shopping cart. Grasshopper also meets ANSI and all state and federal regulations for our types of mowers. The front mount uses a co-developed T-drive transmission that runs directly off the engine, eliminating a drive belt, which lowers operating costs and improves power transfer. The engine and transmission sit on an anti-vibe platform, separating it from the frame. This reduces and eliminates vibration to the rest of the power unit, adding to the exceptional driving and mowing experience. We design and test our mowers to cut in all kinds of conditions. We have over 6 different mowing blade options to fit different applications throughout the U.S. We can side discharge, mulch, vacuum collect, or rear discharge. Grasshopper is currently the only zero turn with a 4-blade rear discharge on the market. This gives us a greater advantage over 3-blade systems as we redistribute clippings better for a cleaner cut, and it cuts through tall, lush conditions using less power and fuel. Next slide, please. Grasshopper has a selection of commercial-grade engine offerings. People buy horsepower, but what they want is torque. In particular, we have a great diesel portfolio for U.S. communities customers. Our diesel units are Tier 4 final emissions compliant, use 30 to 50% less fuel than comparable gas models, and with their 3-cylinder cast iron block construction, offer longer life in commercial applications. These max torque clean diesel units also offer you lower emissions for a more sustainable option in locations with ozone days or ozone restrictions. Our 900cc diesel will soon be joined by a larger 1.3-liter diesel offering coming this fall. This larger displacement diesel unit will give us more torque and no DPF. Next slide, please. As I mentioned before, Grasshopper offers an array of cutting deck options, and we manufacture a lot of the implements at Grasshopper. For example, the PowerVac collection system, no auxiliary motor to service, runs off the cutting deck via belt. We have 2-bag, 3-bag, and metal hopper style offerings. We also have our own high lift option, shown here. It lifts 6 feet into the air and over 30 inches to the rear, so you can dump clippings easily in a trailer or a truck. We build the mower with the collection system in mind, and this shows both in its integrated design and its carpet-like cut. Next slide, please. The front mount Grasshopper has multiple snow removal options. As you can see, we have rotary brooms, snow throwers, dozer blades, V-plow, both in 48 and 60-inch options. We also have a winter cab, fully enclosed with heat and lights. Next slide, please. This is a sample of some of our turf renovation implements. We have a cordless aerator, an edger, a shielded sprayer, a turbine blower, a dozer blade for dirt work, rotary broom for sidewalks and parking lots. Next slide, please. In summary of the product, Grasshopper mowers are designed to fit our customers' different applications. We have engines ranging from 23 to 35 horsepower, cutting decks from 41 to 72 inch, and implements that make a variety of time-consuming, complex jobs get accomplished faster and with high-quality results. We don't just make tall grass short. We take even an average landscape and make it beautiful with a carpet-like cut and grounds your agency will be proud of. And last slide, please. The U.S. Communities contract for Grasshopper mowers is the best of both worlds. It's taking the Cadillac of purchasing systems and combining it with the Cadillac of mowers. We've been working with government agencies since the 1970s, and we understand that your needs are different than the large acreage owner or fleet contractor. This contract is the best pricing for Grasshopper mowers in the U.S., and we have our entire product line available to U.S. Communities customers. This gives you the reliability of a commercial Grasshopper mower and the confidence that every dollar spent gives you the best value. Backed by over 1,000 dealers in North America, we are focused on providing a premier customer experience. We have online pricing for our dealers through a custom design quoting system called QuickQuote. This figures the price for the dealer, has the U.S. Communities logo and contract information, and can be used to submit for requisition or turned into a purchase order. Pricing includes freight within the continental U.S. We also have volume pricing discounts built into the contract for larger quantity purchases. Besides our dealer network providing parts and service, we have online parts ordering capabilities for those agencies doing their own service work. Our parts system is custom based off of your Grasshopper models. A good example of this is Kansas City, Missouri, where we provide online parts schematics to both the Parks Department and their contracted service provider. This helps streamline communication on parts turnaround and reduce downtime. Equipment is set up by trained dealers that are backed by experienced factory reps who also provide preventive maintenance training and assist in diagnosing any issues. I hope that you will at some point drive a Grasshopper yourself and see and appreciate the detail and quality. We are constantly designing, testing, and developing better technologies for mower, and quite simply, there's nothing else like it. Thank you, guys.
Thanks so much, Brent. And thanks for everyone for presenting today. As I've stated at the beginning of the call, this webinar will be recorded along with the slides and will be available at uscommunities.org and on our YouTube channel at the end of the week. And everyone on this call will receive a copy of the slides in a few hours. At this time, please use the chat function to ask any questions that you may have. And also, this last slide outlines the emails of all of our presenters today if you need to reach out to them for any reason or have any additional questions. But at this time, please use the chat function to ask any questions that you may have. All right, I do have a couple of questions that came through. And for the suppliers, can we please answer in the order that you went with AGCO? And then Mahindra, and then we'll end with Grasshopper. So the first question that came through, do you offer on-site training for new equipment?
All right, thanks, Andrew. This is Dave Webster with AGCO here. In terms of on-site training, it would really be our dealers that are delivering that. And when our dealers deliver a product, they will typically go through the operation and maintenance of that product with the people that will be operating and maintaining the units.
You. And Martin, Mahindra?
Yes, it's going to be a similar process for us. You know, it's the local dealer is going to go through and set up like the show them how to operate the maintenance and all that of the equipment when it's delivered. So it's going to be pretty much a similar process, you know, with support by the local Mahindra dealer.
Thank you. And Brent with Grasshopper.
Yes, again, similar process. Our dealer network covers the operations, safety, maintenance at the time of delivery. Depending on the size of the order, you know, if you're ordering a quantity of machines, we may come back and do some additional preventive maintenance training a couple months or 3 months after you've had the equipment.
Thanks. And an additional question, is the contract with purchase, lease, or both?
All right. Dave Webster with AGCO. So the contract is you can have cash purchase or lease or we do have municipal leasing available through AGCO Finance. So all of our dealers have AGCO Finance financing solutions available to them, as well in some instances, a third-party finance supplier might be able to couple up and provide the right solution.
Thanks, David. And Martin with Mahindra?
Yes, it's going to be pretty similar as well. You know, the contract is for purchase, but we do offer municipal lease through Mahindra Finance USA. So, you know, we're going to do whatever it takes to get the owners and operators and the communities, the organizations into a Mahindra tractor.
Excellent. And Brent with Grasshopper?
Yes, the contract is for purchase, but we do use with third-party lease companies that kind of specialize in government or municipal leasing, so we do have those options available.
Excellent. And another question that came through, how are the products delivered? Assuming that these are some large products, so with the heavy machinery, how are those products delivered to the agencies?
All right. With on the AGCO Massey Ferguson products, the products would be initially shipped to the local dealership, and would go through a pre-delivery inspection and any final setup on the configurations, and then they're typically then delivered by the dealership to the physical location as desired by the customer. And products range significantly in size, so sometimes that will be by a pickup truck and trailer, and sometimes it will be by semi truck right to the location.
Thank you. Emma?
Ours is going to follow a similar process for delivery as well. Now, depending on the product size, you know, it could be a small subcompact, compact tractor, which will be delivered by the dealer, you know, after the pre-delivery inspection, on a truck and trailer. When it start getting into the higher horsepower tractors, then it would be an actual semi-truck and trailer delivered to the location as needed.
Thank you. And lastly, Brent with Grasshopper.
Yes, we will have the MOE equipment and everything will be set up by the dealer and delivered, set up, ready for operation. If the customer purchases additional implements or maybe snow equipment, we would come back in and help them set that up closer to use of that time at the end of the mowing season. So similar process, but everything is set up, ready for operation.
Thank you.